Tonight, my sermon is God's Celestial Wheels. What are they for? They're a sign. They're a warning. Time is up. The cup of iniquity is full. Now we'll turn to the first chapter of Ezekiel. Listen. There's been some strange things in the heavens. Some are counterfeit and some are supernaturally lights from God. It happened in the Old Testament times, and it happened through history. They have record of it. Now let's read Ezekiel chapter 1. It says here, "Now it came to pass in the 30th year, in the fourth month, in the fifth day of the month, as I was among the captives by the river Chebar." Now that was a Babylonian captivity, also in the area where Daniel was at that about the same time, almost. "And I was by the river Chebar, that the heavens were opened, and I saw visions of God. And he saw the wheels, and he saw the angels, and he saw the living creatures. But he said the visions were of God." He didn't say they were of Satan. He said the visions were of God. And here's what he saw. These were the visions concerning the celestial things that he saw. On over in there, though, he saw that Lucifer was working too. Now, we'll go on down. We'll read here, verse 4. "And I looked, and behold, a whirlwind came out of the north, a great cloud, and a fire unfolding itself, and a brightness was about it. And out of the midst thereof was the color of amber, and out of the midst of the fire came forth the color of amber." Notice that he even had the day, the month, the direction that it came from, because God has certain times that he makes his appearance. That is, manifest himself openly. He's there all the time. But he manifests himself openly. And when he is going to do something spectacular many times, or he's going to do something that's very vital and important, well, he'll put the very significance of the time and the appearance, like Gabriel came to Mary and what it was all about, and he does that. Now look at this. "And I look and behold a whirlwind." Now that's a sign from God. That's one of God's attributes. Look at here. "And out of the north, a great cloud." That's another attribute from God, showing it's a holy thing coming. "And a fire enfolding itself." See, God is the Holy Spirit, fire. "And a brightness was about it, the glory of the Lord. And then out came amber. Also out of the midst thereof came the likeness of four living creatures. And this was their appearance. They had a likeness of a man." You can read Revelations 4, 7, and 8 around the throne and see some of the same similar. "And then it spoke about they had four faces, and every one had four wings." Now these cherubims and angels and wheels are coming together here. "And their feet were straight feet, and the sole of their feet was like the sole of a calf's foot. And they sparkled like the color of burnished brass. And they had hands of a man under the wings, and their four sides, and they four had four faces and their wings." In other words, the prophet was trying to describe the things as they were coming and the living creatures that were involved. And as we go through here, I'll begin to explain it. Listen real close. "They had wings joined one to another. They turned not when they went, and every one went straight forward. Now, as for their likeness of their faces, they had four, had the face of a man, the face of a lion on the right side, and they had four, the face of an ox on the left side. They four also had the face of an eagle." Now you can go to Revelations 4, 7, and 8 and see the same thing there. Now, he began to tell about the wings joined one to another, covered the bodies. Now these things were supernaturally in here, and they were some form of something that God was showing him. And as, verse 13, "And as for the likeness of the living creatures, their appearance," now here we go, supernatural. Now watch this. Now sometimes in these chapters, it may even take in the forces of supersonic type of a craft we have today, but it's dealing with supernaturalism here. "As for the likeness of the living creatures, their appearance was like a burning coals of fire." Now that there is something that's moving and tremendous fire. And they were in the appearance of lamps. It was just like lamps. "And it went up and down among these angels, and the fire was bright, and out of the fire went forth lightning." See, it had some pulsions behind it. "And the living creatures ran and returned as the appearance of a flash of lightning." Have you ever clocked a flash of lightning? It ran like a flash of lightning and returned. That's moving with tremendous speed. "Now, as I beheld the living creatures, behold, one wheel upon the earth by the living creatures with had these four faces." Now, these were the signs and symbols that were on these things and wheels and the appearance here. "And the appearance of the wheels and their work was like unto the color of beryl. They were emerald, yellow or green looking, gold-like. And they had four one likeness in their appearance." And he goes on to describe that it were a wheel, like it were a wheel within the middle of a wheel. In other words, one wheel and then another wheel going around. "And upon their four sides. And as for the rings, they were so high that they were dreadful, and their rings were full of eyes around about them. Now they had opening like holes in there, and they were full of eyes." The same thing in Revelation 4, 7, and 8. You can see some of the creatures there. And when the living creatures went, the wheels went by them. And when the creatures were lifted up from the earth, the wheels were lifted up. See, it was in unity. The Holy Spirit of the Lord, the glory of the Lord, working with the creatures and with the wheels at the same time. And this thing was going on here. And wheresoever the Spirit was to go, whatever controlled them, then the wheels were lifted up against them, and the spirit of the living creature was with the wheels. And it goes on down. It said they stood upon the earth. And then it said, in the likeness of the firmament above the heads of the living creatures was the color of terrible crystal stretched forth over their heads, like a throne over their head, or like a crown on their head there, like a cockpit-like thing there. And under the firmament were the wings straight forward. And it goes to describing them here. And we'll go down here a little further in verse 26. And above the firmament there was over their heads was likeness of a throne. It looked like a throne. And as the appearance of a sapphire stone. And upon the likeness of the throne was the likeness of the appearance of a man above it. And it says here, and I saw as the color of amber. Now there's that color of God. As the appearance of fire round about within it, and from the appearance of his loins, even upward, from the appearance of his loins, even downward, I saw as the appearance of fire, and it had brightness round about it. And the appearance of the bow, it was like a rainbow in the day and in a cloud, like when it rains. And it was brightness round about it, and this was the appearance of the likeness of the glory of the Lord that was involved in all of this, the glory of the Lord. Now, that is just describing wheels, glory, and angels working together in unity to bring a sign. And the Lord does these things too, and they're around his throne. Now, chapter 2, 8. But thou, son of man, hear what I say unto thee. Be not thou rebellious like the rebellious house. Open thy mouth and eat that I give thee. Now, he's going to give him something. And behold, a hand was sent unto me, and lo, a roll of a book was therein. Now, here's why these wheels appeared, and why the angels came in this signification and symbols, because judgment was about to come. And he spread it before me, and it was written within and without, and there was written therein lamentations, mourning, and woe. The wheels were a sign of judgment. The type of angels were predicting that time was up and that God was about to judge. The cup of iniquity was full. And then we'll go to chapter 3 and 12. Then the Spirit took me up. See, he was to go to the house of Israel and warn them. Then the Spirit took me up. Now, the Spirit was involved in this. And I heard behind me a voice of a great rushing saying, blessed be the glory of the Lord from this place. So, see, it was the glory of the Lord from that place. And I heard also the noise of the wings of the living creatures that touched one another, and the noise of the wheels over against them, and a noise of a great rushing. So the Spirit lifted me up and took me away, and I went in the bitterness of the heat of my spirit, but the hand of the Lord was strong upon me. Then I came to them of the captivity, they were in captivity, and dwelt by the river Chebar, and I sat there and remained there astonished among them 7 days. Now, the Bible said he was taken up in this, whatever it was, the glory of the Lord in these wheels. He was taken up in some kind of a celestial thing, and he was carried away. And when he was set down, he sat astonished for 7 days as a sign. Now, turn with me, and we'll turn to chapter 10, and we'll be finishing this up. I want this on record, because they'll be looking it up here. Now, goes on, if you go, you can see in chapter 10 how that the rider and the inkhorn man come out between them and the cherubims. It says here in verse 2 and chapter 10 of Ezekiel, and he spake unto the man clothed with linen and said, go in between the wheels, even under the cherub, that's the angel, and take the coals of fire from between the cherubs and scatter them, see, because judgment's coming and God's in the land. And the ones that are good, God's going to stand with them, and the one that's evil, he's going to mark them, see, as it goes on over here to show that God put a mark on those that sighed and cried for Israel. Just like at the end of time, the people are going to be marked, which are going to be the Antichrist children. And the Lord has a mark for his children too, the Holy Spirit mark. Then the glory of the Lord went up from the cherub and stood over the threshold of the house, and the house was filled with the cloud, and the court was full of the brightness of the Lord.